Hello guys, and welcome to the Internet Bread, a show where we discuss entrepreneurship, how to make money online, digital marketing tips and tutorials, SEO and more. This is the episode 2 of our 101 ways to make money online series. So basically every episode we discuss one new method to make money online, and today we are going to learn about how to make money on Fiverr. So I'm sure a lot of you must be aware of the website called fiverr.com. Fiverr is an online marketplace for freelance digital services. It was founded in 2010 and since has become one of the largest platforms for freelancers. So basically any skill or any service that you can provide or any skill that you have, you can sell it to a complete random stranger on the internet for as low as $5. And that's how the name comes about, Fiverr. So basically it had many jobs or gigs, as they like to call it, and the website was named Fiverr. So Fiverr has grown into a huge organization now where people can buy and sell digital services, as we mentioned, but it's a two-sided platform. So not only freelancers can sell their services, but of course there are also buyers who can only come to buy service from you guys who are freelancers providing any kind of service. So basically Fiverr accepts everyone. Literally any skill that you may have, you can make money out of Fiverr. So it ranges from programming and technology, graphic design, digital marketing, writing, translation, video animation, business. If you can become a legal consultant or a financial consultant or a business coach to some people are even looking for that on Fiverr. And even some crazy gigs, as like somebody holding a sign and dancing with your message on it. And yeah, so Fiverr is a wild place if you go really deep into the gigs, and you should have your fun and explore the website as deep as you can. And I'm sure you'll find so many creative gigs on Fiverr that you never even can think that, I can make money by doing this. So basically, like, the entry barrier on Fiverr is very low. You just have to get started. Setting up a Fiverr account takes about 10 to 20 minutes of your time, because you will need to fill in in detail kind of like how you make a CV. It is something similar to it, because people are going to come to your profile and they will be judging you based on your profile. Usually when you are a seller on Fiverr, the most number of orders you're going to get are based on your reviews. Okay, so any person placing an order with you is going to first check your reviews. And earlier, back in the day when I started my journey, I knew that Fiverr reviews could be rigged, and they still can, but they are quite nice at combating all these fake reviews by now. So yes, reviews are very important. It's also important to set up your Fiverr account like you do for your LinkedIn account if you're actually serious about it. So you need a proper professional image as your profile picture. If you will see closely, you will spot a lot of people on Fiverr from third world countries. I mean, nothing against them, but they don't really set up their profile quite nice. So you have to look professional, okay? And your bio does the job for your initial orders. Your bio has to be nice. Your story has to be nice. I mean, it's not really important to write your story, but the more credibility, the more information you can give out, the more credibility you will get. And apart from it, I mean, it's quite a simple thing. Organically also, Fiverr pushes your listing, a new account, to enough people. So if you wait for like a week or so, usually people do get their order by the first week. Although I have, when I tried Fiverr, it has been around 3 to 4 years. And by the way, don't have low expectations from the name Fiverr. It's not a $5 marketplace. You can bag opportunities to make 3 to 4 figures, nice, or even 5 figures if you are very pro at it. The people who are usually, if you want to understand basically what kind of gig should you start providing, let's say you are a person who is good at logo design. So just go to the logo design listing on Fiverr and look at the top rated logo design listing. So here I'm seeing a listing in front of me which has 4.9 stars. So I mean, that person is going to get a lot of orders, and he has 495 reviews, and his services start at $50. So a person getting 495 reviews, it means more than 495 people have ordered with him, have purchased a listing, a gig with him. He has designed a logo for 495 people, more than that actually, because not everyone leaves a review. Okay, so you can do the simple math where you multiply the listing price with the number of reviews that they have, and my God, this guy has made $25,000 just by designing logos for people on the internet. And yeah, that's amazing. Like, that's crazy to have. And I don't think this is like in a long span of time. It hardly takes like 2 years to reach this amount. But if you're really good at it, you can really, you can speed up the race. Okay. So yeah, that's the thing about Fiverr. You can get really like, you can make a lot of money on this. And $5 is just the starting point. You can charge upsells. You can do like, if you're providing a service for $5, if you're writing an article for $5, you can put an upsell that I will deliver within 24 hours for an additional $5. Okay. And people don't really care about $5 as such. 5 to 10, 20. These are the sweet numbers that people don't really think twice if the given value is more than that. So yeah, you can add as many upsells as you want. You can do upsells based on like delivery speed. You can do upsells based on revisions. So if you're designing a logo or if you're writing an article, you have to give your standard three revisions or whatever. But if the buyer wants extra revisions, you can charge them for it up to $25, $50 based on the listing price. Okay, so it's not very complicated. As you go to the website, you sign up, you will figure out these things very instantly. And a personal story of mine, and I don't remember when, but I ended up getting an order for $850, and I didn't have great reviews. I mean, I had hardly 3 or 4 reviews, because that's how many orders I had received. And this guy from a very well-known startup, and he turned out to be a person from Mumbai, and they were a well-funded company, and they placed an order for $850 with a person on Fiverr. Okay, although like now being a marketing person, that's just ridiculous to do. Probably the guy was just putting off some weight from his shoulders, giving the stuff to some random freelancer on the internet. But that was a bad approach, nothing wrong to him. Thanks for the order, by the way. But yeah, I did get $850 worth of order on my fifth job on Fiverr. Okay, so it is a crazy place, and you can expect things like this. Although now competition is way more on Fiverr. Like, as I am teaching on this podcast, a lot of people already know, and people are going to hear from here and there, and everyone wants to join Fiverr. So their algorithm is getting kind of tricky, and the number of orders that you will get is now a little scarce, because you're against so many other people. So yeah, but basically you can start making money on Fiverr just by selling any services, literally any services. You don't need to be a professional at anything, I mean, at least to start with, because as you provide these services to people, with their feedback and your experience that you will grow doing the job, you will eventually become better at the skill that you're providing. So even if you're a newbie, you can start by doing article writing jobs. And actually that was the very first job that I listed on Fiverr in 2015 or somewhere around that time. And I never ended up getting article writing jobs, but yeah, that's, I was trying everything that I could. And yeah, you can start with it, and Fiverr is a great place to start. It's a big company now, and it has a lot of rules and regulations. By the way, speaking of the financial aspects of Fiverr, you know that you can make a lot of money, but how much will Fiverr charge you for it? So basically, Fiverr takes a 20% cut out of your paycheck, and that's a bit steep. I mean, when I got that $850 order, I got 20% less, and I was not aware actually of the 20% policy, and because there were costs involved, it kind of became an overkill for me. And yeah, I was kind of sad about it, but anyway, it doesn't matter. It's still some revenue, right? So make sure that if you have something that's going to cost you to fulfill this order, make sure that you add 20% on top of it, because Fiverr is going to take 20% as their commission. That's how the website makes money. So yeah, make sure to add the 20% to your gig. And so it is very cost effective initially. So when you're starting out on Fiverr in your initial days, you can try undercutting the people who you are against. Basically this benefits everyone. It's kind of a rookie move to do so, but yeah, the competition is too much. You can try your creative ways to work around. You can take your Fiverr listing, promote it on Facebook, you can promote it on Instagram, or basically any communities. You can go to Twitter also, and you can go to the hashtags, and you can find the relevant people, and you can pitch them your gig. There is another way within Fiverr where you can contact the buyers and tell them potentially try to get a workaround with them, because basically buyers also have the option to post a listing, and a listing is nothing but their requirement. Their buyers can post their requirement that looking for an article writer who can deliver XYZ in this much amount of time, and if that is something that you can do, you can just go and click on that listing and apply for it, and then the buyer will get to see your profile, and if things work out, you will end up getting the order. But also know that for listings there is more competition than there is like for the regular search. So when a person is contacting you via search, he has already made up his mind that this profile looks clean and looks good, and I am potentially going to work with him. When you are going through a listing, there are 10 other profiles for him to compare, and the chances of you even getting a message back from the seller, from the buyer, are quite tough. So that was about it for how to make money on Fiverr. It's quite easy. Just go ahead and try it. Sell your skills and you will get money in return. And the sky is the limit on Fiverr as well. You can make a full-time income on Fiverr. You can you can get big on Fiverr actually. And if you do so, how YouTube awards its creators with the gold play button and the silver play button, Fiverr gives you special badges like pro verified and stuff, and if you get those, you are going to be the first priority for any buyer who comes to the platform. And you can also start charging premium as you get past 10 or 15 orders. So you will learn it. It's quite self-explanatory. And you should definitely start your online journey on Fiverr. I started mine on that. I did try something on Fiverr. And that's been it for how to make money on Fiverr. The podcast is Internet Bread by Baclinc. So a little background about us. My name is Abhishek Yadav, and Baclinc is a digital marketing company that helps businesses grow. And we thought about also educating people about digital marketing and how the whole, all these stuff work, how to make money online and stuff. So that's why we came up with this podcast, Internet Bread, where we are going to discuss 101 ways to make money online. This was episode 2. Previous episode was Google AdSense. Go and check that out if you haven't yet. And you will find a written description or a blog post about this particular article on baclinc.com, baclinc.com. Okay, it's not B-A-C-K-L-I-N-K, it's baclinc.com. You will also find the description in the show notes of whichever platform you're watching this on. And subscribe and come back for more. There'll be another episode tomorrow and then a day after tomorrow. And basically, we're going to do this for next 100 days. And hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks. Peace.